Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Before I go any further, the question for the week is, do you want me to get, well, it's actually just, we're just going to be hiring them, but this map is quite a small map, so I thought it would fit quite nicely. Do you want me to use Lexion 430 or do you want me to use Lexion 460? They're both small little combines that I think would be perfectly suited for this small little map, and they're nice and shiny and new, which is something that a few people have been requesting, saying they don't really want to see lots of use of the old combines because I focused all on the old machines on the old times maps, and whilst it was nice to see, most people actually prefer to look at the new machines, which is fair enough. I can understand that. So we will go on to a new combine. So I park the tractor up back at the yard, at the dealership, ready to unload all the wood chips. And I told you that I would look for a water mod, and I have not been able to find the one that I thought I found previously for free water. Now, I thought I would just walk back up and I would get this one, and we'll bring it down here, and I'm going to leave it right there, because we're going to use that a little bit later on for some other tasks. Now, the water, I can get water up at the sheep, and that is entirely possible. I'm going to need water over at the mods that I've got there, but I don't think I can get straight from the sheep down to those buildings. I think that there is actually a bank all the way round, so it's not actually going to be possible to go that way. I think I'm going to have to go all the way round. And I also need water down at the yard, and I don't think I can get water down at the yard because I got the one down there as well. So I kind of want something. I would say if I could put something in here, now I did get a placeable mod that I can put water down with, and it's the link for this one will be in the description down below. It's a lizard placeable IBC tank that has water. It's in blue so that you know that it has water. It's all very convenient and well thought out. It's a nice little mod, nothing particularly fancy. I'm wondering if I stick it on this corner, is it going to be in the way of everything? Am I going to be able to squeeze in round there okay? Actually, I'll tell you what. Let's put it up here. How far can I get it? Right, that looks like it's going to have to go there. Okay, so there we go. So there is our water mod. Placeable tank. It's only $100. 100 quid. 100 pounds. Yeah, 100 pounds. That's the one I'm looking for. Right, I'm going to get in and get started up, and then we can start tipping these here and over there. Okay, that's better. Now I can actually talk properly without sounding like I'm sort of semi-choking. Anyway. We need to use wood chips here, and as I explained previously, I do not understand how we can use wood chips to do this. I would have thought logs would be better. I know you can use a sawn timber from the sawmill mod, but I don't actually have room for the sawmill mod on this map. Right, apparently we cannot tip there. No. I am hoping that we can actually tip in front of this thing. I'm assuming we can, because we could in the last map, so there's no reason that we can't. It's just got to get the tip trigger. There it is. Right. Now, it should just stop. I think it was, what was it? Oh, it's 9,000, wasn't it? Right, well, that one's full. The other one's not going to have anything at all, which means we're going to need a couple of extra logs, but well, I want to do something else first. So we'll let that one work away. We can come back and we can do the water in a little bit. We're going to want some trees, and I'm thinking that we could just get away with cutting a few trees in half rather than completely cutting them into three pieces. I think we'll be able to get on with it a little better, and we'll be able to do things a little faster as well. So let me just come out on here, and I will just turn the beacons on. I know I haven't been using them properly on this map, mainly because there hasn't been any traffic on this map, so I've been treating it like it's our own private road. But anyway, before I go and get a few more wood chips, there is one other thing that I wanted to do. And what about tip? I'm assuming that is a tip trigger there for the wood. So there's one thing I wanted to try. I want to see how much money we get for for one tree, for one log. And I did want to try actually doing a little bit of an experiment and do two of them. We get two about the same height, and we'll strip the branches off of one, and we'll put the other one in hole. Right, those two appear to be the same height. So here is our Husqvarna. Wonderful, wonderful machine. And if I rotate round to the side, actually, I want to rotate it. Yeah, I want to go to the other side of the tree. So it will slide out towards... There we go. And now if I lower down... Because I'm not going to worry about stump grinding on this map. I'm just going to slowly work my way through the trees. Because of how close the new farming simulator game is, we're not going to worry about replacing any. Right, it does look like we've actually got two trees in one on here. I have seen that previously. I've seen it once on my old time, not the old times, on hardworking. I had it on there as well. I had exactly the same thing. I had two trees in one. So we've got a tree there. Now what's going on? Let's try cutting again and see what that does. There we go. Right, that's gone through. All right, let me go a little bit higher, perhaps. That might encourage something. Or is this just going to bug the entire map and nothing's going to... Right, oh, it's moving. We had movement. Let me try that again. I'm going to go... Oh, no, I don't want to do that. I want to go much steeper cut this time. It's a shame you can't move while you're actually holding the chainsaw in place. But still, can't help. There we go. Right, now it's bouncing. God, you've got to fall down eventually. Let's go a little bit further. See if I can cut it. I think that's going to be a little bit too steep to cut there. All right, it's going to let me do that. Right, let's cut another wedge. This is the tree that defies gravity. Also, there we go. Look. Oh, it's going to land on my head. Oh, that is terrible. Look at that. Oh, that is absolutely... See, what I was hoping to do was kind of put the chainsaw... Actually, I think you need to put the chainsaw that way, don't you? And then you just kind of run straight up the tree. And that strips the branches off. Because all I want to do is just run a test to see how much difference the money is when it comes to dumping them into the sell point. So let's get rid of that one. Go into here. And now that I've had to slice a bit off the bottom of the tree, it's not going to be all that accurate. Yeah, we were doing some scientific research here, and I thought that we were going to do really good. That way up. There we go. So, am I going to actually be able to pick these branches up at all or not? I'll need to move that tractor out the way. Run down here, and I'll move him. Right, I'll move this out the way, and I'll see if I can get the branches up there ready so that we can tip them in. Right, here is the first tree, and I managed to pick the whole thing up all in one go. I wonder if I'll be able to do this with the beast. It'd be a lot easier if we could. Oh, there we go. Right, that was £5,383. Now let's see if we can get the other one and compare the price with the branches still on. I think I will have to spend a little while maneuvering this one. We've got to bear in mind that this one also has a bit less log on the bottom because we had to cut off all of those slices of timber. I'm not going to be able to balance it quite as well either. That has gripped it. Oh, it's let me do it. Look at that. Right in one. Oh, that's brilliant. Look at that. Right, come on then. And that one was 3,500. Right, so we lost 2,000 on that. I don't think that we lost the 2,000 just from the bit of timber on the bottom of that tree. I know we lost a bit, but I don't think it was all. So... there is a bit of a penalty. It looks... I would guess that you've got a penalty of about... so we lost 2 grand and we had 5,000 to start with and down to 3,000. We lose nearly... I would say that we lose nearly a third for keeping the leaves on. But I can't see that it's going to make any difference for wood chips. I don't think we would have to do any stripping of the wood chips or anything like that. So we wouldn't need to worry about that bit in particular. Now, the next thing that we're going to be doing is... I'm going to get some more logs and dump into this beast. And I'm hoping that we can do whole trees. I just did a couple of whole trees and that seemed to work. So I'm hoping that I can actually, if I just stop right there a second, I will cut down a few trees and I'm hoping then that we can tip them straight into this machine and we'll be able to start up right. So come up to here and I want to start the engine, start the machine up and put the pipe out. I've already put a little bit of a tree in here anyway. Not a massive one. So we're going to put the pipe out? Pipe out. There we go. I already put a little bit in here. It was that little... Right, I think we need to move that one over just a fraction. Just going to chuck them over the other side. It didn't have a huge amount. It was only about 200 litres of chips. It was that little bit that was left lying in the ground last time. I chucked that in between the episodes. There we go. Right, stop that there. That can carry on. So I'm going to get a couple of trees ready, and then we can chuck them in so that we got some wood chips to fill up the other beehive maker. Right, I've had a couple of trees in, and you can sort of pick up the entire tree in one go and drop it in. It doesn't quite fit, and it probably would be better if we cut the tree in half at least. Now, I do have one here that is defying the laws of all known physics once again, so I'm just going to nudge him over. But if you're very careful, it's also quite difficult because we're on a steep slope here. If you're very careful and you can get the end of the tree in, it drags the whole tree in through. I realise that this type of machine isn't technically supposed to do quite like that, but it does work. And who am I? There. See, if I can get the end of the tree in, now if I open it like that, the end of the tree now should go into the machine. And you're going to do it. There we go. Right, it dragged it all in and has chipped it all up. Now, I could do this by cutting it in half. But as I'm going to be doing most of this off screen, I thought I would show you the quick way of doing it. Because we've already had a look at putting bits in. So if you'd like to do it piece by piece, by all means. However, in the sort of the name of a bit of speed and, you know, getting this job done and out the way so that we can get on with doing all the other bits and pieces that we want to do, I'm going to do this the quick way. And this is the quick way. Now, we do have a pallet. I had a notification come up to say, ooh, right, this one's twisting a bit. Look at that. That is, it's like it's drunk. It is actually possible to do all sorts of things with machines past beyond what is technically safe. Anyone who has spent a lot of time driving machines will understand what I mean. It might not be 100% safe all the time, but there are ways to do things that you can still get the job done. There is a slight bit of risk involved. It's not always the best idea, but it can be done. And that is the sort of techniques that I'm employing with this. Probably not the most sensible thing that I've ever done, but we are going to do it. We are going to get this job done. Now, if I open that, put you up like that so that you stay, and I think we'll just do it like, there we go, got it. Right, I'll do the last one so that we got loads. Ooh, our feeder is operating again. I'll do the last one so that we've got plenty of wood chips in the trailer. And then we can head back over and see about moving some of those beehives that are now ready to one of the beekeepers so that they can start actually producing some honey for us. Right, I've dropped the JCB back at the dealership so that we can get ready for the next part. And I'm stuck on that great big hump there. This is not the best place to park this machine. I should probably have to maneuver it round so it's a little bit easier to access and get to. We'll spin round here and we'll run these wood chips back so we can take 9,000 wood chips at a time. We have now got 24,600, which should keep us going for a little while. We can keep them in the trailer and we can keep them there near the dealership somewhere, so that we don't need to worry about getting any more for a little while. Now, if you didn't like the way that I was doing those trees, I apologize. In the last episode, I did cut them up properly and I did put them in properly. I would just like to point that out. And I did most of these trees off camera. I just wanted to show you what I was doing in case you wanted to know a way to sort of do that a little bit quicker, to kind of just get the job done quickly. So that is the way that you can do it. That's a little bit quicker. And technically it's not, you know, entirely accurate, but we have got it done and now we can get on with some other stuff. If I go back to do some more wood chips, I'll do it properly for you if you like. But yeah, I'll leave that up to you. If you want me to do it properly, then say so. If you're not too fast, then yeah, you don't need to say anything. I'll just keep it as it is. I'm just curious to see how many people would prefer that I had done that job by cutting the trees up and putting them in piece by piece. Just bear in mind that if I'd done it like that, I would have showed you more of it, because the little point in going to that extra effort if I'm doing it all off screen. So I would have had more of a video of cutting up trees and placing them into the wood chipper. And so let's just back up here so that we can put this one with all the wood chips he's going to need for a little while. Actually, I was just touching the trigger there. It's a very, very small trigger point, this one is. So there's 9,000. There we go. And I've got another 2.5 lots. That one can take a little bit. So we got one lot of pallets, one lot of beehives ready to go on that particular one. And if I just come forward a bit, I'm thinking that we should use a trailer. You do have to, I believe, use pallet forks to take them off of this, to take them off of all of the locations, otherwise the game doesn't register. Sometimes pallets will and sometimes pallets won't. So I'm thinking that we're going to need a trailer that can carry pallets, because that would just be a lot more convenient. Now, I have a whole host of trailers, because I downloaded, and I'll put the link, the bale transport vehicles. These. Now, I've used, you've got the lorries, you don't have to use the lorries. You've got the lorry trailers, and then you've got these trailers, these are quite bigger ones, medium-sized trailers, and then you've got little ones that can go on, like, pickups, I guess. You've even got a pickup that can take one in the back of it, and then you've got a very small couple of car trailers that you can have as well. That one, I think, just takes one pallet. That one takes two pallets. It's a fantastic set of mods, as bale transport vehicles. I will include the link in the description, and I've included the link for this one. It's already in the hard working description. I don't think I've used it in any of the other maps I've done, but I really do like this mod. I think this is a great mod. This one here is my personal favorite, especially for this map. I think it'd be the right size. Well, anyway, we don't need it today, so I'll have a think about that. I might get a pickup or something like that. But for now, we're going to do it with this one. We just start her up again. And we'll leave the log fork over here, because it's near where we're going to be using the log fork. We'll just pop it down over here out of the way. That one can go right into that corner there. Let's just drop it off. There we go. And I will get these pallet forks on. Back up a little bit. I'm getting a couple of little lag spikes. I'm guessing it's because of that Gia machine thing. Let me get rid of the HUD for the animals. That might help it. And there we go. Because, no, this map is a really small map. I've not had anything resembling lag whatsoever on this map until that one started up. So I'm assuming that that is causing those minor lag spikes. Because at the moment, it's obviously it's going round and it's emptying out its feed bin. Now, that one is already up to 500 on there. And I am not going to attempt to pick up a pallet whilst in cab on this machine. I will not be able to see the pallet forks. It's just not going to happen. Now, what I need to do is very carefully get in and pick that one up. Then we've got to take it. I'm going to actually take this one up to the sheep farm, I think, because the water for that one is right next to it. So that one can start straight away. And then we can fill the one up that's down at the main yard a little bit later on. Right. That... I've just come a little bit too far over. That's the problem with this one when you're trying to pick up a pallet, is the front swings. I mean, it's kind of useful and it's kind of not. Because I'm used to driving a telehandler, I'm not used to the way that the front on this one swings side to side. And I also drive a forklift from time to time as well. So I'm used to having a rigid set of forks, not being able to just swing them from one way to the other. It does make a difference to when you approach the pallet. It does actually make a surprising amount of difference. So let's get this one going here, and I want to get rid of that again. If I can take this, I want to go up to the sheep farm, and then we can get some water. And I'm actually running out of time. I wanted to do a little bit more, so we'll be able to focus quite a lot on the beekeeping mod this coming week, or next week I should say now. Because we've done a lot of the wood chips. The wood chips are now ready. We've got quite a few beehives ready, which means that we should actually be able to start getting some final products out of some of this now. Those beehives actually look quite good from this angle. They are very well made beehives. They are nothing like the beehives that I used to make. Well, I say beehives, I made a couple of bits of the beehives. They're nothing like the beehives I used to use. Let's put it like that. That would be a slightly more accurate way of saying things. Nothing like the beehives I used to use. Now, I'm going to come out of cab a minute. And I believe we put them at the front over here. So I'm going to come out here because I think this would make an excellent screenshot. And yes, I do sometimes talk about screenshots and sometimes I take them in secret. But obviously it's not much of a surprise to everybody because you've already seen the screenshot before you watch the video. There we go. Perfect. So now all I need is a bit of water to go in there. We should have just enough time. Now I can race back really fast and we can get the Bowser and we can drag it up. Am I going to have time to do that? I hope so. I have actually officially run out of time now. So the question that I'm asking for this week is, do you want me to get the Lexion 430 or the Lexion 460? We have a couple more fields in this map that we can still combine, even if we don't combine, don't plant anymore. I've planted one field. We may plant some more, we may not. I'm not quite sure yet. We are going to be doing a lot of work on the beehives for the next... at least next week, because we got water to move around and we've got various other things. I do want to try and get one Bowser full of water up to the top. So let me just come in here and I will stop you right there. And very quickly we'll come over to this one. So yes, the Lexion 430 or the Lexion 460, which is in here. There we go. Two nice little combines. Two wonderful little combines. This one is particularly good. I happen to know that firsthand because I have driven it. It's a wonderful machine. I like that 430. I like the 430. I'm not trying to influence your decision in any way, but I like the 430. Just putting it out there. Letting you know. Right. And get this one on. Did I actually fill up with water or not? I don't think I did. I know I did when I tested that mod to make sure that it worked. And I always test my mods. Always test my mods, although there are some, as you found out... Whoa! Wrong pedal. I am sorry. I'm trying to rush because I really want to get this water in so that we can actually get the bees doing something. Yeah, I haven't filled it now. And I'm a little bit too far up. We'll spin round. Yeah, I do test my mods, although I don't obviously test every single aspect of them, as it's not really physically possible to test everything on a mod before you can actually start using it. You just hope that you catch most of the bugs. So that's about it, really. We'll run this one up and then we can say fare thee well. Next week I will continue with all of the beekeeping stuff. We've got we need to put water in, we've got beehives being made, and we've got some spare wood chips there so we can make more beehives. So we got plenty of beehives to do. I need to get water here up to the beehives up the top. The beekeeper up the top here. And I need to get water down to the farm to the beekeeper down there. And I also need to get water over to one of those buildings over there because they use water. We need cereals to the other one. We do have some cereals in storage. So we'll be able to use that. Overall, I think we will do all right. If you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give me a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then could you please tell your friends about me, get them to come and watch me as well. That would be awesome. Now, if I can back in here just a little bit further, and I should now be able to unload. I think press R. Yes. Pipe goes on. Excellent. That is working beautifully. Look at that. We now have honey being produced. Ladies and gentlemen, we now have honey. And I can fill this one up again, just in here. If I back round. I know, I'm going over time. It shouldn't be. Right, if I come up round here, you have to avoid the sheep. And come up close to the water. It's not a good idea to drive into the pond either. But if I come to there, I can fill this one up and then I can take it straight over there and I should be able to empty it out again. But I can do that bit off camera. So yes, I will continue on with this next week. And until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye and see you later.